Hello and how's it going, everyone? And welcome back to The Current, a news magazine show produced by the seniors in the South Elgin High School Beacon Academy. I'm your host, Daryl Barnes, and believe it or not, today's show marks the fifth quarantine edition of The Current, meaning it's the fifth time where I've had to clean everything up in front of the camera so you guys don't have to see my typical mess. Exhausting work, yes, but it's worth it to bring you guys some entertainment and news for when you're stuck in the house with nothing else to do. So without further ado, let's get to what we have coming up on today's show. Coming up, PJ and Gavin review one of the movies from one of their favorite franchises, Star Wars: Revenge of the Sith. Then later on, Sarah sends out a special message to the high school graduating class of 2020. But before we get to those stories on this pretty light show, we're gonna kick things off with a little harder hitting news as Penny brings us the latest on the recent decision IHSA made regarding the 2020 spring sports season.
Here at South Elgin, the fields are eerily quiet for the annual spring season full of sports. But due to COVID-19, IHSA had to make a tough decision regarding the future of this season and state tournaments for high schools across Illinois last Tuesday.
So the board of directors made the decision. That was a result of mainly the decision that came from the state governor to put schools out of physical attendance through the end of the school year. And with that recommendation, and without students being in attendance, the board at that point just decided that we couldn't go on with spring state championships and spring sports if students weren't going to be back in session.
What I feel is that I think that IHSA made the right decision. They didn't make it lightly. They made it for the right reasons. This whole pandemic is bigger than sports, unfortunately.
Nothing can really prepare you for when you see that you're not going to be able to play your senior year. It's pretty heartbreaking, to say the least.
I just don't want to give up hope that we will have a chance to finish out our season in the right way.
And this closure of some type of spring sports over the summer may be possible for seniors.
The window of opportunity still is available, but a lot of things have to happen with being granted permission from state government and medical leaders to do so.
To my coaches and my team, thank you for everything you've done.
These past 3.5-4 years that we've had as a team has been awesome.
Like I said, I just want to say thank you from the bottom of my heart.
I wouldn't be where I am today without all of you.
We're really coming together as a family.
This has been just a blast for me. It's been a true blessing and a true honor.
Even though it's uncertain if this is the last time that I'm stepping on this field that I called home for the last 4 years, what is certain is I'm going to cherish these lifelong memories that these sports have given me and all of the seniors here at SEHS. We are all heartbroken that your senior year did not go as planned, but just know that your community is here for you and can't wait to see what you will overcome. For The Current, this is Penny Kapdukakis.
That's right, I almost forgot that last week we learned that music means it's time for some quick trivia.
Star Wars: Revenge of the Sith was released in what year? 1997, 1999, 2002, or 2005? Although with it being the sixth Star Wars movie to be released, Episode 3 was released in 2005.
So for a review on the third prequel of the original Star Wars saga, here's PJ and Gavin.
Revenge of the Sith. Come on, Gavin. This is a good one.
So, number one, the music. John Williams is a king. The best composer who ever lived. Ewan McGregor and Ian McDiarmid are both amazing. And that's it. That's all I have.
What do you mean, that's it? What about Anakin's fall to the dark side? What about Order 66? That entire segment, like, is starting to make me tear up just thinking about that.
But the biggest problem is I don't care about Plo Koon, because he never said a line once. And since I've watched the TV show, I like Plo Koon a lot, but
Clone Wars really helps with the movie itself. Like, the characters we were talking about, like Plo Koon, Ki-Adi-Mundi, Aayla Secura, no one knows who they are. And you just see them die, like, okay. When you're watching Clone Wars, you're invested with these characters. You get to spend a lot of time with these guys.
Episode 3, on its own, with no help other than its trilogy, is awful. It's one of the worst movies. One of the worst Star Wars movies, I should say.
But when you're watching it as a part of the whole Star Wars saga, it's good. At least we can agree on that, right?
Even then, there's a lot of filmmaking laziness.
What laziness?
Like, the whole thing was just shot in a studio in green screen, which is like...
Okay, that's...
And
I can agree on
and
that.
Not to mention George Lucas's dialogue.
You are so beautiful.
It's only because I'm so in love.
No. No, it's because I'm so in love with you.
So love has blinded you.
Okay, one thing that I can agree with that's just so stupid is how Padme dies. She dies of sadness.
She's lost the will to live? What is your degree in poetry?
So since our ratings are completely different, we're gonna do two different ratings. Mine's gonna be more lore-based, Gavin's gonna be more film-based. In regards to the lore, I give this film a 3.5 out of 5 stars. Gavin, how do you rate Revenge of the Sith?
Well, PJ, I rate this film 1.5 stars because it is terrible. I'm really good at rating. I should do these from here on out.
Thank you guys for tuning in to this installment of Gavin and PJ's Movie Reviews. Tune in next week for our review on The Social Network.
Now for the final story of this episode. I know, I was hoping for a longer show too, but with the final story for this week, Sarah created this special message for the high school senior class of 2020.
Dear South Elgin High School seniors.
Hey seniors.
In class of 2020.
Class of 2020.
Class of 2020.
Hey there seniors.
Hey class of 2020, it's Miss Mack.
Hey seniors, this is Mr. Mora.
Hello, South Elgin High School, class of 2020. This is Miss Rebecca.
To one of my favorite classes ever, dear class of 2020. This isn't the way we hoped to send you off into that real world we kept telling you about and preparing you for. You've been dreaming of this moment for so long, and it was ripped out from under you.
I know this is not how you picture your last days at South Elgin High School, and believe me, neither did I. But if there's one thing I know for a fact, is that you're going to be okay. You'll always be known as the class who lived.
But hopefully, as time heals, you will create new memories and have amazing experiences.
You're resilient, smart, and creative. If there's any senior class that can get through this, it's you.
But I want you to all know that you all matter, you are still loved, and you guys will come out of this stronger than you came into it.
Thank you for all the memories and laughs over the past 4 years. I wish you the best of luck in everything that you do.
Always challenge yourself and keep growing. May you all have the best futures possible. We'll miss you all very much.
Wishing you congratulations and best wishes with your future endeavors. If you can make it through this year, you can make it through anything. Congratulations.
For the ones that I've gotten to know this year, the past 4 years, it's been fun. I have the memories and the pictures to prove, and I hope you do too.
Don't let your life pass you by. Weep not for the memories.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, guys. Good luck. We miss you.
And unfortunately, that's about all we have for you guys today. But on behalf of everyone here at The Current, we want to thank you for tuning in to today's show. If you have any story ideas or just want to send us some feedback, feel free to email us at thecurrent20@gmail.com. Anyways, guys, we hope you all continue to stay safe and healthy. So signing off till next time. For The Current, I'm Daryl Barnes. We'll see y'all next time. And until then, have a great day.